So let us try to derive it now. So let's assume that this is the bar magnet. Draw a cylindrical shape, all of you. I hope you have copy and pen with you. You're not watching it like a movie with a popcorn in your hand. Okay, so this, just to be, you know, just to make it simpler, the diagram, I am taking it as just a cylinder, the entire solenoid. So this entire solenoid, if I treat it like a cylinder, okay, first let me draw the basic things. So these are the two axes. Okay, so I'll say that this is axial and this one is equatorial. Okay, and the dimensions of this solenoid, the radius is given as A, okay, and the length of this solenoid is also given. The length of the solenoid is L. Okay, so L is a solenoid length, and the current is flowing in the solenoid that has a value of I. Capital I is the current. Okay, you are measuring all the distances from this point. Let us say this is O. Okay, and number of turns per unit length in this solenoid is given as small n. Okay, so given all these things, I want to find out, forget about magnetic dipole moment right now, okay, just try to find out magnetic field at this point P, okay, which is at a distance of small r from this line. Okay, and just like in case of electric dipole, we have assumed that, what we have assumed, distance between the charges, we have said that distance between the charges whenever we find electric field, okay, is very less compared to where we are finding the electric field due to a dipole. Okay, so distance of the point where you are finding the electric field, that distance is very large compared to the distance between the charges when you were talking about the electric field due to a dipole. Okay, similarly, when we are finding electric field due to this solenoid and we are treating this entire solenoid as a magnetic dipole, then our assumption here is, okay, this is 2L, sorry for that. So this is 2L, just like in case of electric dipole, you have taken distance as 2A. Here I'm taking distance between these two poles. Let us say this is North Pole and this is South Pole. Distance between these two pole is 2L. Okay, so it's an analog of electric dipole where 2L is the distance between the pole, and the 2L is very less compared to where we are finding the magnetic field. All right, now just spend some time and see, can you get an expression of magnetic field in terms of whatever is written here? Forget about a magnetic dipole moment. The hint is you can take rings like this, you know, you can take imagine a ring like that. The width of this ring is dx, and this ring is at a distance of x. Okay, just spend some time in it and try to see whether you can get something. You know, you may not be able to get the final expression, but at least try to analyze how you can, you know, get the equation. Another hint is a question to you. Do you remember the magnetic field due to a ring along its axis? So you have to use the formula for magnetic field due to a ring along its axis, and you will be able to find the magnetic field due to the entire solenoid. Okay, I'll just write down here, magnetic field due to a ring along the axis. So let us say this is the ring, okay, this is the ring here, current going through is I, number of turns on this ring is n. Okay, I am trying to get the magnetic field at a distance r, or let us say at a distance x from its center. At this point, which is at a distance x, okay, the radius, let us say, is a. What will be the magnetic field? You guys remember, magnetic field in this particular situation would have been mu naught n I a square divided by 2 times of a square plus x square raised to power 3/2. You guys remember this? Yes or no? Please message. Okay, so now can you find out magnetic field due to this ring? Just because of this ring, forget about the solenoid. You just have to find magnetic field due to this ring, which is of width dx and the radius is small a. Okay, get the magnetic field due to this ring here at a point P. How far is this point from the ring? This point P is at a distance of r minus x, isn't it? This is x and r is from the center. So distance of the ring from this point is r minus x. So get the value of magnetic field due to this ring only. First of all, the number of turns on the ring, that will be equal to what? N into dx, fine. And this x was what? This x was distance from the center of the ring to the point where you find the magnetic field. Okay, so that x over here is actually r minus x. R minus x is distance from the center of this ring to this point P. Okay, so we can write magnetic field due to the ring will be equal to mu naught n into dx I a square divided by 2 times of r minus x whole square plus a square raised to power 3/2. Fine. So this is the magnetic field due to this ring only. All right. Now, in order to get the total magnetic field, I need to integrate this, right? Total magnetic field will be the integration of this magnetic field, isn't it? And I know that direction of magnetic field along the axis will be straight. So I don't need to worry about any components here, because all the magnetic field due to all the rings, okay, wherever you consider ring, you can consider ring here also, there also you can consider, anywhere you consider along the axis, the magnetic field will be always along a one straight line. So you just have to integrate it. And the limits of integration, yes, Saimir, limits of integration, you are integrating what? You are integrating x, right? And x is a distance taken from this line, right? So you're going from this point, you're going from this to that, isn't it? So you're first going left and then going right. So the limits will be minus L to plus L. Fine. So that's what the limit is. Now we are going to use an approximation which is not very obvious over here, as in the usage, how it is getting used. When you try to integrate this, it becomes very tedious. Okay. But then if I use the approximation straight away, what is this approximation? That R is very large. Okay. R is very large compared to L. Okay. And I know that X is smaller than L. Right. So if X is smaller than L, then R will be always much greater than X. Fine. And if R is much greater than X, can I say that R minus X is approximately equal to R only? Yes or no? So I have effectively removed this variable from integration. Because it is very small, it will hardly affect. It will hardly affect anything. So I'll say that magnetic field B is integral minus L to plus L mu naught N I A square into dx divided by 2 times of R square plus A square to the power 3/2. All of you comfortable with this? Any doubt till now? Please message. Any doubt till now? This is very important derivation. Okay. So now that this expression has come, I can, you know, further make it more simpler. I can say that R is so large that it is much greater than the radius of the solenoid also. Okay. So if I say that, then even this I can drop off. Even this is gone. So what I'll get is magnetic field B is equal to, now I will take all the constants outside, mu naught N I A square divided by 2 R cube. So I will get integral minus L to plus L dx. So it becomes straightforward. Fine. So this you will get as mu naught N I A square into 2L. When you put the limit minus L to plus L, you'll get 2L. Divided by 2R cube. Okay. So this is what you get as magnetic field due to the entire solenoid at a distance R from the center of the solenoid along the axis. Fine. So I say that this is the magnetic field which is axial. Okay. Now, you guys remember what we were trying to do? We were trying to find magnetic field as a function of magnetic dipole moment M. Okay. So can you modify this expression further and get the magnetic field, which is this, in terms of magnetic dipole moment? Quickly do that. Can you first type in what is the total magnetic dipole moment of this solenoid? M is equal to what? Total magnetic dipole moment of this solenoid is what? All of you type in magnetic dipole moment through any loop is current into area of the loop, right? Now here we have total number of turns n into I into pi a square. Now how will you get total number of turns? Capital N is what? Capital N is number of turns per unit length, which is small n, into total length of the solenoid, which is 2L. This is capital N. This into I into pi a square. This is what is the magnetic dipole moment M. Okay. Now please modify this and do it quickly now. It's not small n IA, it is capital N IA. Small n is number of turns per unit length. Once you get the answer, please message that you have got it, or just put a thumbs up that you have got it. Once you got as a function of M. Okay, Purvik got it, Ritvik got it, Sai Mihir got it with caps on. Okay, a lot of people are getting it, right? So let me write down the expression here. So what you'll get is this. Mu naught divided by 4 pi multiplied by 2 m by r cube. All of you got this only? M is n I a square into pi into 2L. So denominator and numerator pi will come. Okay. So this entire thing, this thing is capital M. So I have multiplied and divided by 2 also, so that I get nicely this mu naught by 4 pi outside, which is like typical magnetic field constant. Getting it? So we have just now derived magnetic field along the axis due to a magnetic dipole moment. Fine. Now you guys remember electric field due to a dipole moment along the axis, how much it was? It was 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by r cube. So you can see how similar these expressions are. Okay, the direction of magnetic dipole moment is the direction of the area. Curl your hands along the direction of current, you'll get the direction of magnetic dipole moment. Okay, so this is axial. Now, if I correlate with electric dipole moment field, and I know that along the equatorial plane, electric field, if you guys remember, was 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus p by r cube. So the magnetic field will be what? Magnetic field should be mu naught by 4 pi into minus m by r cube. Okay. So the formulas look analogous. Fine. Now we will take up a few more. We'll just discuss couple of more theoretical aspects, and then we'll start solving, numericals. So just a couple of more things.